was a mistake to go, so it's a mistake to stay. If we make
Republican Ron Paul is the only candidate in his party against the Iraq war from the start. A 10-term congressman from Texas, he's also an obstetrician who's delivered more than 4,000 babies.
Vote for the principles of freedom.
And he was the libertarian candidate for president in 1988. I spoke with both men in Washington on Friday, starting with Congressman Paul, who had a nice crowd assembled on the street.
How's it going?
Hi, how are you?
He also came with a little news. After a burst of fundraising in the second quarter, he has more campaign cash on hand than the former frontrunner, John McCain.
I think some of the candidates are on the downslope. We're on the upslope. So can you imagine what it would be like if we do as well in the next quarter and quadruple our income and our numbers?
How do you account for it? What do you think happened?
To simplify it, I would say I think people have underestimated the number of people in this country that are interested in a freedom message. Just being free, free of the government, you know, oppression of us, whether it's on our personal liberties, our economic liberties, and they certainly like the foreign policy of non-intervention. You know, just stay out of the internal affairs of others.
Let me get into that message of non-intervention, starting with Iraq. You were the only candidate on the stage in the Republican debates who was against the war in Iraq from the very beginning,
right.
And you want the troops to get out right now. But don't we have a responsibility to those we leave behind?
We have a lot of responsibility, but it's to the American people. We have it to our troops. We need to get them out of a bad situation. We need to get them out of harm's way, and we need to protect the American taxpayer. It's a tragedy of what's happening, what we're going to leave behind. But we don't know it's going to be as bad as those who are predicting bad things. Just remember, people who are predicting these very, very dire things to happen are the same ones who predicted it would be a cakewalk.
So you're willing to pay the price even if that is the price?
Well, it's not much of a price to save our men and save our taxpayer and change our foreign policy to be more sensible. Think of Vietnam. It worked out much better than anybody predicted. We're achieving with Vietnam what the founders advise us to achieve with everybody, friendship and trade. Not a belligerent attitude of forcing our wishes on other people.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise to urge the Congress to think twice before thrusting this nation into a war without merit.
You started out as a very lonely voice in the Republican Party, but it seems like more Republicans are inching your way, at least towards starting to pull out from Iraq. Do you believe that come next year, the Republican Party position will be, it's time to withdraw, it's time to get out?
If they are, they can't. They won't have a prayer in the election. I mean, where are their political instincts? That's why they're starting to shift. I mean, we'll take them any way we can get them, you know, support for a more sane foreign policy.
You would completely pull out of the Middle East.
The main motivating factor of the hostility of this country, I've said it before, it's absolutely true, is our presence in the Middle East. The sooner we get out of there, the better.
Have you ever read about the reasons they attacked us? They attack us because we've been over there. We've been bombing Iraq for 10 years.
That's an extraordinary statement. As someone who lived through the attack of September 11, that we invited the attack because we were attacking Iraq. I don't think I've ever heard that before, and I've heard some pretty absurd explanations for September 11.
Rudy Giuliani said you didn't know what you're talking about.
Well, that revealed a bit of lack of knowledge, to put it mildly, on his part, because there's been so many books. Our CIA defends my position. The 9/11 report defends my position. Paul Wolfowitz defends my position.
So no regrets for what you said?
Well, no, but he was demagoguing. Everybody saw through that. He was the great patriot, and he was trying to say, I'm blaming America. I'm blaming bad policy. I'm not blaming our victims.
So you think Rudy Giuliani knows better than what he said?
He knows better now. I think he probably just looked at it superficially. He probably looked at the politics of getting the attention of hawkish type conservatives, and he got the applause, so he was probably reinforced. But I'll bet you the week later he wasn't nearly as reinforced, because they're using different language now, the general Republican leadership, on this whole issue.
But President Bush says if we retreat from Iraq, Al-Qaeda, all of its allies are going to attack us here at home.
Well, I disagree. He believes that, and he believes it sincerely, but I don't think he's correct on that, because I think we have done a great service to Osama bin Laden inadvertently, because it's a recruiting tool for him. But what has happened to us? We have become isolated from the world. They charge me with, are you an isolationist? No, isolationism is being practiced
today.
Aren't
you proud of being an isolationist?
I don't like the words.
You'd also pull out of the United Nations. You'd pull out of the International Monetary Fund. You'd pull out of the World Bank.
Yeah, but George Washington wasn't for all those groups either. We didn't have a president for that until after World War II. So I don't think that's isolation. I want to trade with people. We have more enemies today and more enemies and less friends than we have ever had in our country.
You ran for president in 1988 as a libertarian.
The Libertarian Party and the Libertarian message offers a choice. It offers a choice for the American people not to have to vote for the lesser of evil.
You're running as a Republican this time. Why?
Well, I was elected to Congress 10 times as a Republican. That's a pretty good reason. I've been able to deliver this constitutional, very libertarian message to my district, and they like it, and they reelect me. And it's practical. Third parties, the laws are biased against them. Unless you're a billionaire, you can't even get on the ballot. So that's not very democratic.
You've also really built up a reputation for living out your libertarian principles. You served, as you said, 20 years in Congress, but you're not going to take a congressional pension.
Right.
As an obstetrician, you never took Medicare or Medicaid for your patients.
Never.
You didn't allow your children to take student loans for college?
No, because my goal was that they would work and I would help them and that it wouldn't have debt. But not to borrow from the taxpayers. It's not the government. The government has nothing. They want to steal the credit from somebody who's trying to start a small business someplace. So if you steal credit out, you know, that means there's a pain and suffering for somebody that's invisible. So I wouldn't participate. I consider that an immoral act.
Do you think the Republican Party has stayed true to its small government principles?
They haven't stayed true to their principles about less government. What happened in this administration? They took it over, and we had massive increases in entitlements, and we have international conflict. So the party has lost its way.
What's success for you in this campaign?
What's success? To win is one is the
That's
goal.
That's not going to happen.
Do you know for absolute? Are you willing to bet your every cent in your pocket for that?
Yes.
You are. Okay. I thought so just when I ran for Congress. I wouldn't bet anything I could have been elected to Congress. The odds are great. The odds are difficult, and I know that. But I would say that what has happened so far is about 100 times greater than I anticipated. And I think that we have surprised a lot of people already, and I think we're going to surprise a lot more.